Hey folks, Ben from Snowy's here today with the Oztent Redgum HotSpot Heated XL Sleeping Bag.
Get it.
This is a big, roomy sleeping bag with integrated pouches that you can put a HotSpot pouch in so that you get heating in your sleeping bag without the need for electricity. So this is how the Oztent Redgum HotSpot sleeping bag comes when you buy it. This weighs just under 4 kilos. This measures about 45 centimeters by about 35 centimeters by about 25 centimeters. And that's rolled up quite tight inside there from the factory. We'll roll this up later and show you how it all packs back in the bag. When you open your bag, when you buy it, so this is the bag. It's a zippered bag. So you've got a zip that runs around the top here, so it's not a stuff sack. Hopefully it's oversized enough to get the bag back in. We'll find out a bit more on that shortly. You also get 3 HotSpot pouches included. Now that's these pouches here. They come in their own little bag. You click this little metal thing inside here and that heats this pouch up to about 53 degrees. Now the concept of that is you can put it inside the bag. We'll show you a bit more on that in a second because I just want to also mention that you do get a couple of straps here so that when you roll it up, you can secure it with these straps before you put it back in the bag. Now I want to talk about the HotSpot pouches before we go any further here. So there's 3 of these in here. This is the HotSpot pouch. As I mentioned, you click this, it warms up and it then becomes a heat pack. You can also use it to cool it down and use it as a cold pack as well. To reset it, you put it in boiling water and it goes back to this gel here. So once you've got it heated up, you can put it inside this little microfiber pouch that's included here. And what the sleeping bag has got down the front here is 6 pouches. So there's a zip here. And there's also another one here, here, and here. So that's on top of the torso. And then down at the foot section, 2 more zips, 1 here and 1 here. So you can put a total of 6 pouches in here. Now it doesn't have to be these HotSpot pouches. You could just use a heat bag or a wheat bag, I suppose, if you're able to heat them up. But the benefit of these is they heat up without the need for microwaving or anything. You just crack that little thing and it heats up at night. You just need to reset them the next day. So these go inside these pouches here. So I grab my HotSpot pouch, I slide it in there, I do that up. I've now got that HotSpot pouch in there warming me up. So I can essentially have this panel here full of HotSpot pouches above my torso. It's gonna be a bit of a weight on top of you. That's the only thing. If you don't like a lot of weight on you, you might not find this comfortable. But you also have, probably find most people are gonna use the foot section there, a couple of pouches in there to keep your feet warm. I'll take that out because I now want to go into the features of the bag, because you can use the bag without these HotSpot pouches, and without that it just becomes a really durable, good quality sleeping bag. The exterior is a ripstop cotton canvas, so a nice durable material on the outside here. Inside is a flannelette material, and in between the outer and the inner is Oztent's, what they call their T-Therm insulation. So it's a synthetic fill to give it the warmth of the insulation in there. And all together, they have had it tested to give you a comfort rating of around about 6 degrees, and that is tested to a standard, so it's a reasonably accurate comfort rating, and that's tested without the HotSpot pouches inside. In terms of overall dimensions of the bag, it's about 240 centimeters from the foot right up to the top of the hood here. That's a loose measurement because this is sort of a dynamic fabric here, but it's about 185 centimeters to the top of the neck here, and about a meter across in width. So heaps and heaps of space across this way. The general construction of the bag is quite good. It's sewn through, so you've got panels of synthetic underneath, and you've got this stitching on the outer here to hold the synthetic in place. That stitching is offset inside here, so the stitching on the outside doesn't match up with the stitching on the inside, which means you've got a continual sort of layer of warmth, and the stitching isn't pinching any of the insulation together at any point inside the bag there, so it is quite an efficient construction. A few more features inside the bag I'll show you shortly, but I just want to run over the zip first. This is a right-hand zippered bag. You can join left and right-hand zip bags together. So if you get a left, this is a right. If you get a left, you can zip them together with the zip on the side here. And what that means is the zipper terminates at the foot here, and there's a second zipper that runs underneath. Now, if you want to use this zipper independently, so say let your feet hang out, you need to undo this, unzip this one. You can then do this zip back up if you like. If you just want to let your feet hang out the bottom, do that one up, and you can unzip this one so that you've got an open foot section at the bottom there. A couple of loops here, they're just hanging loops if you wanted to hang it in a wardrobe or whatever for storage. I'll come back up to the top where I just want to talk about some of the features inside the bag. So along the zipper here, there is a bit of a draft tube here that sits or kind of pinches the fabric in here against the zip. So this, there's also flaps in there. So that's designed just to stop any draft or hot air escaping out the zipper there. Further up around the neck, there is this baffle here that runs around the bottom and the top with a drawstring in it here. So you can actually draw this around the top of your shoulders if you like to trap the warm air in if it is a really cold night. And then you've got this extra large hood here as well, which also has a drawstring in here. So you can pull this over the top of your head if you like to trap the warmth in around your head. Now this is kind of a three-dimensional hood as well. So even when it's sitting flat, this kind of sits up. So it's got some reasonably technical or efficient features around the bag to make it nice and warm. In terms of care of the bag, they don't specify anywhere I can see that says it's machine washable or anything, but I would say if you're using this on a gentle cycle in a washing machine, then you should be fine. Just use mild soaps or a hand wash is always a good way about it. Now, in terms of space inside the bag, I'm 185 centimeters and I'm gonna have loads of room inside this bag here. 100 centimeters in width. It feels like an endless sort of space to the end of the bag there. I'll crawl right in, heaps of space for my feet. So it's not a three-dimensional foot section. It does just taper down to one point here, but there's loads of fabric there to give my feet heaps of space without them feeling like they're gonna crack cold spots. I've got my feet at the end and this is still overhanging the end of this mat here. So I've actually got loads of room to lie down. Zip this right up and I've got heaps of room in here. This, if I pull this partway over my face, I can feel it getting a little firm against my feet, but I've got heaps of fabric to tuck up around my shoulders here and keep me nice and warm. This neck baffle sits sort of up around about my shoulder height. So if I was to tighten that, it would just bring all this in a little bit to keep the warm air in and heaps of room. The hood's plenty big enough that if I tighten this up, it would sort of snuggle my head nice and comfortably around there. So heaps of room inside this bag and this flannelette lining is quite nice to sleep against. Now, in terms of packing it away, you could, if it's a stuff sack, you could just stuff it in the bag. But this is a zippered bag, so you probably need to fold it or roll it to a degree. And you do have these extra straps here to kind of secure it. So I'm gonna have a go at just rolling it. We'll fold it in half. And we'll start rolling from the head end. Now, I'm doing this on top of a mat, which is probably a bit more sort of realistic because you're not always gonna wanna be rolling your sleeping bag on, say, a dusty floor of a tent. You probably wanna be doing it on your mat. But I'll roll this up without too much effort and see how easily we can get it in the bag. Now, it's probably gonna be better to roll this up without the hotspot pouches in it, because that's going to make it heavier and bulkier to roll up. These straps seem like they're going to be plenty long enough, and they are, to go right around the bag. I've still got heaps of extra space there, so they haven't gone tight on how much fabric they give you on the straps. I'll put a couple of them on there, and I'd say this is actually going to go back in the bag relatively easily. That rolled up pretty comfortably. There we go. Then we'll put the bag over the top. Let's see how we go. Yeah, heaps of space. So Oztent have actually been sensible about how big they make this storage bag and given it a bit of an oversized sort of feature. So you can still fit your hotspot pouches inside there if you want. You could probably also fit your small pillow, possibly a liner or something in there as well if you're taking that to warm it up. You could fit a fleece liner inside that as well. So that's the Oztent Redgum HotSpot Heated XL Sleeping Bag. Great option for almost any climate, really. A 6-degree comfort rating is good for all but the warmest of summer months. But if it is used in the winter, you can put those hotspot pouches or some heat bags or something in there to warm it up, to keep you nice and toasty overnight. You can check this out online at snowies.com.au, where you find them at our lowest prices every day. If you've got any questions, let us know down in the comments below. Subscribe to our channel for all of our latest and greatest information, or check out some other cool Oztent products on those ones down here. I used to say